suppose I don't mind playing first again here. And ooh. This hand's quite reasonable. Turn 2 Augur with Ultimate Price, Wrath, and Sphinx Revelation. I get to play like a normal Esper deck, actually. Nice little Esper control deck. One of the reasons I actually do like this deck is that it gets to play, I'm not going to say aggro, but gets to play both the control role and kind of like the mid-range role, where it can actually kill the opponent with Lingering Souls and Sorin tokens and whatnot. Whereas the normal Esper deck basically has no outs to actually win the game besides Nephalia Dranyard. Granted, it's still a pretty good plan, but I feel like this deck doesn't sacrifice that much in terms of the inevitability, though it does some, whereas gaining like a much stronger like mid-game. Let's see how this one goes. We've got just the fact that we have a shock land and then the M10 lands is pretty nice. You actually just want to draw one shock land and the rest M10 lands, but which is exactly what I have, so let's go ahead and battle. Played against a variety of decks so far. Let's see if that continues to hold up. Alright. I would say that's likely. Ooh. Gideon's pretty nice. Let's see how he does this game. Wouldn't mind hitting here. Yeah, definitely Lingering Souls. And another revelation is not needed, whereas Lingering Souls is kind of the perfect card here. One of the reasons Augur is good in this deck is it finds Lingering Souls. Alright. This time it probably is Reanimator, not tokens. Yeah, I'm going to say that. Well, didn't hit any lands. Did hit Angel of Serenity and Unburial Rites, though. Alright, let's just cast the Lingering Souls. Really would like to draw a land this turn. Since Angel's coming out at some point here, can't really stop that unless I draw Syncopate. Though if my opponent just plays an Elf, Mulch hitting 2 lands. Alright. Yeah, so Unburial Rites will happen next turn, whether I like it or not. And sadly I drew that, which was probably just the worst draw. Let's just attack for 3. I don't think playing another Lingering Souls is great. Problem, if I play another Lingering Souls, then my opponent just goes Angel, kill 2 of your tokens, and then remove another Angel. Whereas now, at least I can Ultimate Price the Angel in response to the trigger and stop the recursion. If my opponent even does go for it. Centaur Healer, yeah, that's fine. And an Elf, that is acceptable also. Alright, wouldn't mind a land here. I think I do just draw a card. Well, yeah, I'll leave black up. Alright. Well, wouldn't have minded leaving blue up there, actually, just to bluff a counter, but nah, the Syncopate's really the only one at that point, so it's not too big of a deal. And then I still have the ultimate price for the Angel, which is nice. Vault of the Archangel is actually pretty annoying here, since it makes my plan of racing a little harder. Though I do have a Wrath as well, and then a bunch of Revelations, so I can potentially go to the long game reasonably well here. Syncopate helps. Just getting the Unburial Rites, both sides of it, is pretty nice. Obviously, I don't have any Syncopates or lands to really use one right now, but in the future, it'll be good. Alright, are we going for a... Just going to go ahead and take it here. Are we going to go for an Angel or not? I'd imagine that my opponent does want to get an Angel out here. Alright. And again, my guess is it's going to hit my 2 Spirit Tokens and Angel Serenity. Though, hopefully it can hit like Restoration Angel, Angel Serenity, and like only 1 Spirit Token. I would not mind that at all. Ooh, Centaur Healer, Restoration Angel. Centaur Healer, Restoration Angel, Restoration... Alright, no, not even the Angel Serenity. Well, I'm still just going to go ahead and Ultimate Price it. Oh, that's pretty. That was pretty good. That worked out quite well, actually. Vault's kind of cool. Definitely getting a Gideon out here. Gotta get some value. Plus 1. And slam in the air for 2. We're going to be chumping the Centaur Healer instead of having Gideon go down here. Gideon actually gives me a way to kill my opponent. Like, every time I Wrath, I get to smash with Gideon for a bunch of damage. I can also potentially just plus 1 it and then Wrath. Like, it's actually fairly strong in this matchup. Grizzly Salvage hitting a Borderland Ranger and a bunch of lands. Alright. My opponent might not even have unburial rights here, which would be nice. I don't know how likely that is. I took a land, not the Borderland Ranger. At least it didn't. I'm not getting Craterhoofed quite yet. Yeah, I mean, Wrathing next turn is going to be pretty good. I guess I assume I'm Wrathing, but I might not even be. If I don't have to, I certainly won't. Alright, well. Let's go ahead and chump it up. Like, if I'm not fighting against an Umbrella Rights here, this actually seems like it could be pretty good. Let's see. So I want a Revelation this turn. I've got a Lingering Souls I can also flashback if I want. Let's just plus one Gideon. I don't really want to run Gideon into an Arbor Elf. The Vaulted Arcanum doesn't actually kill Gideon because it's becomes indestructible. Let's just hit for one here and then chump the center. Oh, Restoration Angel. Right, right. That's fine. Opponent gains 3, goes to 16. I guess I can... Yeah, I'm certainly not going to waste a Wrath here. I'll let my Gideon take a little bit of damage. Because drawing 3 cards this turn is going to be much, much better than any other option. And again, I really do need to save this until something actually big comes out. And then I can also Wrath plus Lingering Souls in the same turn, which is going to be pretty good. So I assume Gideon's going to get smacked by at least 2 of these, if not the third. Alright, at least I'm not getting Craterhoof this turn either. So, I've got a Vault. I can also potentially Vault away my opponent's Restoration Angel, which hopefully that keeps my opponent off my back for the moment, though it seems like it should be kind of clear that I've got a Revelation. Maybe not. Either way, the Vault is, I think, doing good work for me right now, since my opponent's actually hesitating before attacking him. If I could get no attacks out of this turn, that would be insane. Oh, I guess not. Alright, well, let's just block the Angel and take 4. Here, well, rather Gideon. We'll go ahead and take 4. And then I'm just going to draw 3 cards, and who knows what I'll encounter after that. Blue, white, and with 3 Revelations in hand, I certainly need to start casting them. If I had another Wrath, I don't mind pulling the trigger here. I'd plus Gideon again. If I don't, yeah, I'm still plusing Gideon. And I think this time I will threaten to use the Vault here. Let's flashback a Lingering Souls and play an untapped land. I guess it's just slightly better to play a Drown Yard here because I can drown myself and hit more Lingering Souls. Gideon's still quite large. Another Grizzly Salvage? Yeah. The Craterhoof Behemoth could be annoying here. Alright, hit an Unburial Rites, but no Craterhoof. Putting Thrag Tusk in the grip. Alright, Unburial Rites does mean that I'm likely going to need to cast Wrath, though it's kind of annoying now that Unburial Rites is going to hit Angel, and then Angel is going to kill my 2 tokens and flashback and hit another Angel, as I imagined the play. That could not happen, I guess. We'll see. End of turn, Grizzly Salvage does make things harder to plan. Another Grizzly Salvage, hitting Lotleth Troll and more Thrag Tusks. Putting another Thrag Tusk in hand. Alright, I get the idea. It's going to be difficult to kill my opponent here. But I think I can do it. I've got still a fair amount of gas here between the Wrath and then 2 more Sphinx's Revelations, and Gideon's not dying this turn without a Craterhoof, which could be coming. That costs 7. Arbor Elf is 8. Though, do I die from Craterhoof? I don't think I do. So I take 14, 22. No, actually, I think I like exactly die. Or 23 minus the... I get to cast a Revelation for 2, so I get to go to negative. Looks like Gideon's going to die. Well, better than me dying. So, let's see. I can't stop that. I can kill... I actually think I need to kill the non-Craterhoof creatures, because if Craterhoof dies with Unburial Rites in the bin, that could be more of a problem. And that leaves Craterhoof in play with me at 11. Well, also an Arbor Elf in play. Alternately, yeah, that actually seems okay for the moment. So let's block, block, use vault. Well, like I said, better than being dead. Though, this is going to be a little tougher now. I was kind of counting on Gideon there. Let's just cast an auger. I think I'm going to wait on casting Sphinx of Revelation for another turn here. Ooh, syncopate's not bad. And do I want to just keep syncopate mana up? I can syncopate. Actually, I can just do this. Now that I hit syncopate, it's a lot more profitable to pass without playing anything. Even though I can't syncopate on burial rights right now if my opponent plays a land. But I can also revelation for three here, which I think is fairly decent. Save the last revelation for the largest. And I've still got plenty of planeswalkers to hit. Though, yeah, that crater hoof was kind of annoying. That was not what I was hoping to see. Opponent's also on 21 cards, which is probably not likely to be enough for me to mill him out, but it's worth considering. Alright, Ivison's Pilgrim, followed by Orzo of Charm on... Okay. I guess that's fine. I mean, that does some damage to me, but I can live with it. So, hey, the opponent's down to two Thrag Tusks in hand, plus one on Barrow Rites in the bin, plus one card that I do not yet know. So, looks like a Thrag Tusk. Oh, Restoration Angel. Well, that I'm afraid I have to counter, sadly. Well, let's just syncopate it for a very large amount. Yeah, because otherwise I just die to this thing. Because this does 9 plus 5, I'll get a negative 3 or what have you. Storm count of 4, by the way. Alright, so I got a 5. Opponent's on just the 2 Thrag Tusks in hand, but an Unbarrow Rites in the bin, huh? So do I want to... I think just playing Lingering Souls here. No, because then I die to an Angel. So I guess I do have to Supreme Verdict. And then next turn, you can Unbarrow Rites the Crater Hoof, but I'll have a Lingering Souls in play. Alternately, I can go up to 10. I really do have to get this off the board, because otherwise Unbarrow Rites on a Restoration Angel to blink the Crater Hoof, I think, is just too much. So I can do that, then I can cast a Lingering Souls. Just one, though, not flashing it back. And this puts it... I'm dead to any creature, but or any cheap creature from the Crater Hoof, but I'm not dead currently to just the Crater Hoof. And if he reanimates Crater Hoof, he can't play anything else this turn. And the next turn I can cast a Revelation for 6, which gets me into a decent spot. Though if he just casts Crater Hoof this turn, or Thrag Tusk this turn, and then Crater Hoof next turn. Then attacks me for 14, and I have gained 6, 11, 13. Alright, so even if it doesn't have anything, I could be in trouble here. Alright, well, that helps, since unless he's got an Orzo of Charm, I don't die here. Alright, I'm at 1, and now I get to cast a Giant Sphinx's Revelation. I think I just pass, or... I could Lingering Souls here, because the Unbearer Rites is gone. I mean, I'm dead to another Unbearer Rites by a lot, but casting a Lingering Souls actually seems pretty good. I have two Revelations, so even if I only get to cast one of them, this nets me a bunch more life. And the Vault might make my opponent think twice before attacking. Or that. Alright, so still not dead here. I'm at 1, but I'm going to get to Revelation and stay at 1. And luckily my opponent hit Thrag Tusk with that, so instead of another Angel, I think that would have actually been worse for me. But, yeah, I'm still kind of on my last legs. That last on Barrow Rites is going to be really tough to beat. Or rather, the third, not even the last. That was a good hand. So, now I've got to deal with a bunch of Thrag Tusks, but... I've got a good hand to do that, so let's go ahead and Wrath, keeping up Syncopate for the next Unbarrow Rite. So tapping the vault at this point. I've got millions of Thrag Tusks in hand, but that's okay. I've got Ultimate Price, so I can actually just cast Sorin, leaving Ultimate Price and Azorius Charm up. And that should keep me from dying to most things. So, I don't even have to choose an option there. I don't have the option to pay the 2 life. I actually think I'm in good shape now. I get to kill whatever. If, like, a Crater Hoof comes at me this turn, I get to just Ultimate Price it. If, like, an Angel of Serenity gets summoned, I can also Ultimate Price it. I can grind out a Thrag Tusk with most of the things I'm doing. And I've got a Syncopate for one, I guess, if I really need to. At this point, I'm most likely going to just win via decking. It's going to take a while, but between Sorin, the flashback of any other, well, I guess more Lingering Souls, but this mainly this last revelation, I think I'm going to end up being able to grind out the opponent. So now, do I want to Azorius Charm it? I think I actually just Azorius Charm it and then mill my opponent. Since I think that ends up, I'm going to want to start milling anyway, and this way I don't have to use Ultimate Price. I want to keep that if I can. Put another one of those into play. Play this tapped. I actually think smashing for one to get me a life is probably pretty good. Then next turn I can probably just cast a big Revelation, find the second Dranyard to speed up the clock. Ooh, what is this? Thrag Tusk is, yeah, that's fine. Definitely not countering that, especially with a Vault of the Archangels out. I think I'm in pretty good shape. Already used Dranyard, I'm not casting. Actually, I think casting Revelation here is pretty good. This card's pretty nice. It is not a bad card. I think no one would ever say that. Alright. Go up to 6, draw a Snapcaster, yeah. And another Dranyard. I think we have ourselves a winner. And that would be me, because I'm going to drown my opponent cruelly and slowly. Alright, put that into play. Play Dranyard. Not even casting Tamiyo. I can just chump the Thrag Tusk forever, vault it, my Vampire Tokens if I really want to. Can also, like, Sorin a bunch of Thrag Tusks if that is my desire. And I've got Snapcaster, Syncopate, Ultimate Price, Azorius Charm. So I have a good amount of action here. Yeah. Sorin, coming at Sorin, huh? Let's see, so 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I can actually vault and use both Dranyards in the same turn. It's a pretty good turn. Right? Boom, boom, boom. Yep. It looks like I do even have enough. So yeah, I think I will be doing that. Let's go ahead and block there. Use Vault of the Archangel. And I guess it doesn't really matter how I tap since I'll have enough to use everything all the time. I guess the only way this could be bad is if I now have to use a Syncopate and can't use both Dranyards, but if this is just not a Thrag Tusk, I will allow it. Alright. I guess I could have not killed his Thrag Tusk so I could soar and ultimate his Thrag Tusks. But I don't think I need to do that. So as long as I don't die to a Crater Hoof at this point, I think I'm in okay shape. Well, there's the Unvarial Rites for the Crater Hoof, but actually let's just go ahead and do that. Opponent gets a Thrag Tusk, I gain a bunch of life. Not want to pay the life, and I just pass. I've got enough to just kill a bunch of all the Crater Hoof tokens if I really need to, or not tokens, rather, the Crater Hoof and anything else that might come at me, so like the Beast token. And double Dranyard, my opponent just dead. So, and I assume post board's better for me, but that might not even be the case. Maybe if I board in too much junk, then he can beat me down with a lot less trolls or what have you. So this looks like the version, yeah, with Orzhov of Charms and a lot less trolls and pretty and Centaur Healers and whatnot. So the kind of more mid rangey like beat down sort of nonsense seems reasonable. All right, what would be this? Thrag Tusk, sure. Thrag Tusk, I don't mind. And then flashback, Unbearer Rites on Crater Hoof, and won't actually do anything. I guess I can just syncopate it. Yeah, why not? Do it for some amount. Not that my opponent really had much hope there anyway. So the plan normally is to bring in Appetite for Brains and counter spells and purifies. Though against the mid-range aggro version, I don't think you want to go too incredibly deep on that, just because you end up with not enough ways to stop your opponent from just getting you down with creatures. So I think taking out the augers is okay. I think I will not put in negate, but all the removal counters seem okay. Appetite for Brains and purifies do seem good. I like ultimate prices a reasonable amount though. Azorius Charms are a little less good. You can probably take out a couple of those. Snapcaster, I think, is decent with all the cheap counters, but or and rather, well, I don't have any cheap counters, but the Appetite for Brains is. But I don't really see much of an option. Unless I don't really want to board out Sphinx's Revelation, and you can't board out like all the Azorius Charms. Guess you could take out one Snapcaster. Lingering Souls is not spectacular, but it's okay. Maybe it's good with. I mean, Gideon also seems pretty decent. All my cards are good, so maybe this is too many board cards for this matchup. I guess I'll just try taking out the Azorius Charms. I don't know.